What the heck is A/B testing? That's what we're talking about today, and I hope to get you excited as well as give you an idea where the heck to start with this. So what is it? You get it, right? I take A and I take B, I compare it, and I see what does well in the real world, and if one wins, I do more of what works. I'd be A/B testing cupcakes, recipes, whatever. In this case, I really actually care about newsletter subject lines and, of course, websites. So we're talking about A/B testing websites. What do I mean? Well, let's break it down into the different types of pages I like to test. First off, landing pages. Landing pages, first page that somebody is experiencing your site. This is not just the home page. This is usually determined by Google organic search and what comes up the highest. Next, pages that we specifically design for people to go to and then make a conversion, take an action. We call these like conversion pages. And then finally we have just testing for page templates. So think about the frame of your site, the menu, the footer, the sidebar even, that kind of chases the entire site around. We can test on a given page what happens when we make a menu change or add something to the header. And then that can have incredible impact across the entire site, but we can test it just like in the corner so we don't screw up a bunch of stuff and then roll out that change site-wide. So let's go into an example. The main landing page of College Line NYC, they're a former client of Whole Whales, and we were able to look at their homepage. You're looking at option A and option B. You can see the differences. One is just making sure that you can search for and find what you're looking for, and option B is just, you know, quick options for what you're gonna click on. The goal here in this case was to increase engagement, stop bounce rate, and help people get where they're going. Which did you choose? I hope it was B, because that one actually outperformed A by 21%, which is crazy. That much more engagement, people finding what they need and going where they are. It was a simple change, huge results, a plus 20% difference of engagement. Landing page example number two, BarackObama.com circa 2008. This is actually a well-known case study. It comes out of the folks that created Optimizely.com, by the way, one of my favorite A/B testing services. And in this classic example, their whole goal here is get your freaking email, right? Obama's running for election, right? We need your email so we can communicate. Looking at A, looking at B, right? B was a video. He's a tremendous orator. He's telling his story, convincing the voters in the way that only he can. And in A, we have a static image. Just a picture of his family with some text. Which one won? Maybe you know the answer. I'll give you a second to choose if you haven't already, A or B. It was A. A freaking wins here by a landslide, in fact. A 40% increase, which led to 2.8 million addresses, converting roughly into $60 million additional, just because they changed this page, right? Now think about what that means. If I increase the efficacy of this page by 40%, what did I just do to the top of that funnel? What did I just do magnifying the amount of money potentially that we can spend now? Example number three, we're gonna talk about conversion SEM pages, a search engine marketing page. In this example, stroke.org, one of Whole Whale's clients, we had a landing page that's designed to get you to subscribe to their newsletter, their brain alerts. You have option A, option B, as always, playing at home. Choose wisely. This decision will haunt you the rest of the video. It probably doesn't come as a surprise that B wins, but B wins by 25%, which is crazy, right? One out of four people kind of difference. So when you're looking at those sort of landing pages and you're like, yeah, it's good enough. Yeah, there's some clutter around, but I don't think it makes a big difference. It makes a big freaking difference. You know, think about your current pages. If they kind of look busy, if there's a lot of things around, all we did here, we just tore things out, made it simple, focused the ask, cleaned up the form, added some contrast. This wasn't a whole huge lift, but I'll tell you what, 25% month over month increasing subscriptions, that makes a hell of a difference. Next up, page templates. So this example, going back to my awesome days back at DoSomething.org, we had a campaign called Picks for Pets. Page template means what is the layout that we have? And in this case, in this campaign, what they were doing was they had cute pictures of pets being sent in so they could get adopted, but each individual pet technically had its own page. Top of that page, you see we have this value statement. 1,000 shares gets me a bed. Next up, share me. No question of what has to be done here. Make this number go up. We already have this sort of social proof idea of how many people have already liked it, but this is the page template design, and we did a lot of testing to improve it. Why I show it to you is because it's so simple at this part where we've torn out everything else and just focused you on what you need to make happen, and in fact, a green button beat a red button here by 10%, so that, you know, goes to show, it's just about contrast. Believe it or not, this led us to become, while we were at Do Something, the number one talked about Facebook page literally on Facebook. We eclipsed 2 million at that point talking about it. So really powerful when you get this right. Short text, picture, action, trigger, focus, and then you can get some pretty incredible results. It's one thing to say like, oh, let's just get lucky, create A-B tests. Here's how we like to think about it. We've mentioned before BJ Fogg's behavioral model. Super recommend like studying and looking at this guy. Here's a super complicated chart. All it's saying is, look, behavior is a sum of motivation, ability, and trigger. What does that mean? Motivation, do I wanna do it, right? Am I motivated to do this thing? Ability, can I do it easily? Like, is this gonna take 5 minutes or 5 days? And then finally, like, trigger, what do I click? Like, what is it? Now we're gonna talk about the most important thing of A-B testing, well, of even your site, it's copy, right? Content is king. It's not just like, oh, some fancy design. Writing matters. If there's no text on your website or it's all ipsum lorem, people aren't gonna do the thing you want them to do. So here's some things to think about with regard to copy. First, one call to action. That's what matters. Having multiple things distracts people. People are easily distracted. What's that? You don't want that to happen. Be concise. Enough said. Next up, think about the copy that influences decision making and why we want to behave in certain ways. So first, let's think about focus on need fulfillment when we're writing our copy. It's not what we have. Maybe we have sort of a stroke newsletter, but in fact, that can be positioned as updates on information you need to know about stroke and your health. Things that position it in a need fulfillment manner. Next, social proof. This is like, look, no one wants to be the first penguin in the water. That's how you get eaten by sharks. You don't want to do that. So we look for, as people, a lot of sort of social proof in that 10,000 people have liked this on Facebook, or the like, any validation that looks like a lot of people have already done the action, so it seems safe. It seems like the standard thing to do. Next, authority, right? Third-party validation, like as seen on TV, or as featured in CNN and something else. These kinds of things kind of like give the reputation of whoever recommended you and whatever like authority they have onto your product, validating what you have out there. Next, we've got scarcity. Oh my God, time's running out. Fear of missing out. Anybody? FOMO? It works, so use it. And finally, reciprocity. If you give something away for free, people are more likely to then say, oh my gosh, you're so awesome, and then give you their email or their follow up with a donation. A lot of these ideas are covered in a book called Influence by Robert Cialdini. Super brilliant guy, wonderful book, definitely recommend it. Finally, design. Look, you should have a designer. I'm not a designer, I've got a talented one, and she's wonderful. Here are just some guidelines, at least to keep you focused. Number one, focus, right? One thing that we want the action to be, the design should point to that. Next up, we're looking for simplicity. Just remove everything that is not to the point. Keep it simple, stupid. It works. Next, color, consistency, contrast. These are all your friends. Think about people that are not so good with colors or even contrast. You want to make sure, especially your action button, has high contrast with the rest of the page so people can pick it out quickly. Next up, we've got mobile friendly. If your freaking page is not mobile friendly, then like, seriously, come on. People on mobile devices are people too, and they can convert. Use a hero image. You need a sort of like great image to grab people, but it doesn't take over. What's good, you know, it's like babies, great sort of happy kids, eye contact, all of these things build into great landing pages. That's a lot of stuff. We've covered, you know, methodology and copy and all of these things, and you're thinking, oh my gosh, there's so much stuff to do. Relax. The only way you can mess this up is by not doing it. Just get started with this. Don't wait, you know, 6 months to put out an A-B test. Don't wait until, you know, you have time eventually to test your subject lines. Do it now. You know what matters. You've seen just a taste of the results. And there's plenty of ways, plenty of free tools to get you going. That's what I got for you. That is A-B testing. Don't stop A-B believing, okay? Subscribe up here as always. Send us comments, questions, things you want us to cover, concerns. Tweet them at Whole Whale. And finally, I'm gonna give you a choice. Video A or video B. The choice is yours. I personally, I'm a video B fan, but that's just me.